Nuh alayhi salam, he said to his people, Istighfar Rabbakum, seek Allah's forgiveness. What do you seek Allah's forgiveness from? From sins that you have committed. In other words, the point is, people will fall into sin. This is human nature. If you don't fall into sin, ma'ana that you're a prophet. Now this is not going to happen for any one of us. We will fall into sin. But haqs, Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he says, in his book, Al-Wabil al-Sayyid, he says, وَرُبَّ سَيِّئَةٍ أَدْخَلَتِ الرَّجُعَ أَدْخَلَتِ الْمَرْأَ الْجَنَّةِ وَرُبَّ سَيِّئَةٍ وَرُبَّ حَسَنَةٍ أَدْخَلَتِ الْمَرْأَ النَّارِ. You know what I mean? He said, sometimes a sin could be a reason for why a person enters the paradise. I said it correctly. And sometimes a hasana could be a reason for why one enters Jahannam wal'iyadu billah. Allahu Akbar, what does this mean? Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, when he described this, he said that when a person commits a sin, what happens after it of regret, sadness, worry, remorse, turning to Allah, istighfar, tawbah, begging Allah Azza wa Jal, dropping into sujood, crying, begging Allah Azza wa Jal to forgive the sin. And all of that that you did after the sin was a reason for why you entered the paradise. And this is what Allah Azza wa Jal wanted to see. A humiliated slave before his hand. This is what Allah wanted to see. And on the other side, a person could do a hasanah. But then after that, develop arrogance. Man of Allah, I did something. What are you doing? And you start developing this arrogance. Man of Allah, I've done a lot. I've done a lot. And I'm the one who got up at night, made wudu, I prayed, I came to the masjid. People can see me. I'm always here. You know? And I feel bad if I miss a day because one of the boys is going to talk about me. This hasana of yours, look at the arrogance that it developed inside of you to the point where it threw the person in Jahannam wal'iyadhu billah. Ikhwana, please understand. It's not about the hasana and the siyya'ah that you do. What il hasana, what is it doing to you? Was siyya'ah, what is it doing to you? If a siyya'ah, if the sin, because there is not a single person among us, even the most knowledgeable among us, even the most fearful of us to Allah Azza wa Jal that's sitting among us, as much as he protects himself, he needs to fall into a fitna. He will. There is a moment of ghafla, unawareness and heedlessness that he will fall into. There is a shahwa, a desire, a temptation that he will fall into. There is a moment of ghadab, an anger in which he will fall into, as Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he mentioned. For the idea is, everyone is going to cop it. We're all going to be tested in that. But how do you react to the hasana? The believer to the sayyah. The believer is supposed to respond to a sayyah. They're supposed to be like emergency alarm bells ringing in. Rush to al-istighfar. Rush to at-tawbah. Like Nuh alayhi salam saying to his people, فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ. Seek Allah's forgiveness. Ask Him to forgive you. Beg Him to forgive you. As a result, Allah Azza wa Jal wouldn't just say, alright, I forgive you. Yeah. Allah Azza wa Jal is so happy with the servant's forgiveness, seeking forgiveness and repentance, that Allah Azza wa Jal does beyond what you're going to expect. Beyond what you expect. You earn Allah Azza wa Jal's pleasure. Allah Azza wa Jal says in that ayah, يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا. He will send the sky upon you in abundance. He didn't say, يُرْسِلِ الْمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ. He'll send water upon you. And why do we limit it? He said, يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ. السَّمَاءَ يعني everything of goodness in the skies. As we said, the mercy, the angels, the barakat, the rain, all of it, he'll send it. مِدْرَارًا. Frequently, time after time, it doesn't stop. وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ. يُمْدِدْكُمْ يعني يُمْدِدْكُمْ مَدَّ. He'll stretch you out as far as the eye can see with مال, money. First, he mentioned as-sama, which refers to water, because water is a reason for money. When water comes down, things grow, people sell, they make money. Right? That's the chronological order of this. وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ وَبَنِينَ and children. وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ. The gardens will come back to life. وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا. the springs and the rivers and the ponds and all of that would be filled up once again because of what an istighfar